After the break, I take a lesson in judo, visiting a martial arts school whose numbers have grown and grown since the earthquake. Christchurch Judo School has seen its roll numbers increase since the February earthquake, offering students exercise and a break from the difficulties of day-to-day life in Christchurch. Is there a big market for judo in Christchurch?
I think there is. I'm developing it.
Good
idea. I like discipline for children, and I think a lot of parents, you know, appreciate their children learning self-defense and like fit children and focused children. I think it helps to focus children when they study a martial art.
You get knocked over in a fight, you've got to get up fast. And so you put your head one way, put your legs the other way. You keep your back curled like a ball and you roll backwards quickly to get up fast. You go forward, you touch down and you go forward and you hit. It's about the tackle, the hit.
The first earthquake was significant because it broke the old dojo and we couldn't go back in there. Even though it was green stickered, it was really effectively red stickered because the walls were falling outwards on it. It was very dangerous and it's going to be demolished. So when we moved here, the second one, it rattled this place a wee bit and we had liquefaction inside through the floor slab up sand under these mats here. It pushed the mats up into a pile and we had to get rid of all the sand, and then out the back dojo had the water and sand, and it flooded the mats out there, and we had to wash them all down, dry them out, and we got some mats out drying now from the most recent one. They're outside. Most of the old halls went down in the earthquake, so a lot of martial arts training dojo, the places people train, were lost in the earthquakes. So
how has this school grown in numbers since the earthquakes?
Well, we came from about 120 with our combined martial arts clubs, and we've grown to 200 in the time. And since, it's been pretty tough, you know, trying to grow it, but we've achieved that through the enthusiasm of the students, really, because we haven't been able to afford to advertise much. We only had these tiny little bits of paper we give out to the children and say, tell your friends about it. And you know, it's been pretty well word of mouth.
What sort of age range are the students?
From 4 through to oldies, 55, 60 would be the oldest, I would imagine. But we basically have got lots of children. I think for the time that the children are involved in the sport, I think they get a lot of value out of it because it's intensive. It's very intensive, it's a full-bodied, very physical, and they get a lot of development out of it, personal development. Meets you up. We're used to dealing with people that are resisting. Because
Yeah.
Judo, you resist each other all the time.
Yeah.
And even if you want to resist, I can still knock you over.
Whoa!
Whoa!
See, I knew that was coming that time.
Yeah. Yeah. And then grab my elbow. Yeah. And then just kick out my foot this way. Yeah, kick it out this way. And just sort of fuck it there. Yeah, good. Yeah, you're good. You kick it. Yeah.
Time to shoot.
Yeah, I can feel the pressure in the joint. It wants to snap here.
So you, you just have to try and pull back.
Yeah.
Ah! Was it important for you to reopen as soon as possible?
For the children. For everyone, yeah. For everyone. Because even the adults like the stress relief of coming to training and fighting each other. They really enjoy it. They really enjoy training together and a hard physical culture. There's about 90 children, and we're training Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday from 4 till 5.30 for beginners. We train two areas for the children. I have two coaches for the children's judo classes. And I do one side, and my friend Hitoe teaches on the other side, and we coach slightly different age bands. They have to be reactive. It's very interactive. And they have to be intuitive to survive. And so it's quite hard to get a child to be intuitive. And for instance, if we're fighting each other and I do something to try and throw you and you don't put your body in the right place to defend that technique, my technique works. It's credible. You fall over. Right? As a result, there's an action and a result. If you don't respond in the right way, you fall over. So it requires you to respond in the right way. Next time, you have to adjust your technique. And so it requires interaction, and it requires cunning and lots of skills.
What are your hopes for the future of Christchurch?
For stability. I hope we can resettle our centre. Our damaged centre is really, I felt really affected by seeing the church so broken, our cathedral. And I want to see our people, the children particularly. I have concerns for them because some of them are living in hard circumstances right now. I want to see them assisted to grow through this troubled time. And the parents to realise that the children, need a break, and lots of kids do. Lots of kids need a break. They need help, and sometimes their parents are so busy they haven't really got time for their children, and just because it's a busy time as well.
Would you say that judo or the sports are a part of the solution?
Yeah. Just any sport is good for children, and I think, as I said before, particularly sports like judo. Are really physical, and the rugbys and the netballs and all those very physical games need encouragement, and get the children away from inside, get them out and exercising. It's very healthy. It's a good therapy for children and adults.
Thanks so much for joining us tonight. We'll be back next week. Until then, take care.